I was born in 1945, November of 1945. It was the end of World War II, and a lot of soldiers were coming back, and 9 months later, babies were born. And my father was a part of that the post-war success. The thing that I remember most is probably my dad knowing everyone's name in town. He would ask questions either about the weather or the children or the price of cattle or whatever it might be. And I still take that as a model for how I greet people and approach the day. My mom ironed in a south window, so it was always warm. And whatever that wonderful aroma is from clothes being ironed is still my favorite aroma in all the world. For some reason, my teachers always wanted me to sit up front. Now I know why. Back then, I didn't. You know, and I'd always rank well in initiative and industry and those kinds of things, but many times it would have on there, talks too much, talks too much. I think when I grew up, I always wanted to be in ministry somehow. Part of that was just the culture of where I lived, and the most exciting people were related to the church. I could see the ministry as the way to engage the world and embrace the world. I'm at church on Sunday night, and the preacher gets up and says, I've got to be gone next Sunday to El Paso, and while I'm gone, I'll ask Jerry to preach for me. The next Sunday night, he was gone to El Paso. We had the regular old service, and there's 15 people there, and I preach a sermon when I'm 13 years old. The pastor was wise enough to call out the called. I had no idea that I had any gifts for ministry, but he did. Linda and I met our first semester at college at Eastern New Mexico University. We actually were in the same English class. Now, I look into her eyes. She had dark brown eyes and dark brown hair. Every hair was in place. Everything was manicured, you know, to the nth degree. That's a unique woman. She's different from every other woman sitting in this room. And so I called her and asked if she'd go to the Mardi Gras party with me. From that first date, I knew that was the woman I wanted to marry. And all the pressure was off. And I no longer had to perform. And no longer had to impress. Marry well. Please marry well. Please think about that. Please decide in advance what you want in the characteristics of your life partner. My favorite memory at Judson would probably be the night we turned university. We had everybody out here on the flatland. And we had a big screen, we counted down, and at midnight we became university, and we shot off fireworks and woke everybody in Elgin up at midnight. Do something you like to do, for heaven's sake. Enjoy what you do and feel a little bit guilty that you get paid to do what you do because it's so much fun. The thing about Judson students is they have the energy, the creativity, and the vitality of students of any other college I've been to. But the difference about a Judson student is there's a peer pressure toward righteousness to be better than average, better than the social climate of the rest of the world. Joy is the most infallible evidence of the presence of God. I would want to see Judson being known for the joy that's evident on this campus. Inch by inch and row by row, we're going to make this garden grow. All I need is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch and row by row, someone bless these seeds we sow, someone warm them from below, till the rain comes tumbling down. It probably means you do all the little things, just inches and rows, and someday the rain will fall, the ground will be warm, and the crop will flourish.